Welcome to Malvern Hill on Ultimate General Civil War, playing the Union on Major General Difficulty with the JMP mod. Before we get started, I wanted to go over a couple of things quick. Pandakraut posts test versions of the mod on the Discord prior to officially releasing updates for the mod. Most of the time it is minor stuff that you would not notice if you just watch my videos, but I've recently updated to 1.28.3 test version 4. So you may notice a few changes. Pandakraut expects to do a formal release in a couple of weeks. I'll go over all the updates then, because I don't know for sure if everything that's in the test mod is going to be released as is, or if there's more changes coming. After taking 33% casualties at Gaines's Mill, I turned around and lost 40% here at Malvern. There are several alternative spawning locations for Malvern. You do not need to hold the northern VP throughout the entire battle, but I went ahead and did that here. I fought the battle 3 times, and each time the AI became fixated on pushing my eyes out of the wooded area to the right of the northern VP. In Forefall's legendary playthrough, he eventually gave up to the position, so that might be a smarter play because the AI seems to become slightly more passive once it controls that area. The old strategy of falling back to the 2 southern VPs is still legit, but don't expect the AI to give you the left and right flanks to sneak past it and take the VP at the end. You're likely going to need to push all the way back to the northern VP and fight all the way. Deployment is 1 corps of 20 units and a 2nd corps with 10 units. You will get the entire 1st corps at the start of the battle. 10 of them will be there for the yellow deployment box at the beginning, but as soon as you click the start battle button, you'll immediately get the rest of your corps. Gaines's Mill was very sensitive to scaling, so any extra unit I made increased scaling. Even small ballast units increased scaling for me at Gaines's. Here at Malvern, building smaller ballast units in the 2nd or 3rd corps did reduce scaling. I had to play around with it for a bit to find the sweet spot. One thing about the mod is that bigger units will always do more damage than smaller units, but smaller units will be more efficient. For example, 3 artillery batteries with 6 guns each will be more efficient than a single battery with 18 guns. However, since divisions are 1 unit smaller in this version of the mod, you have to decide what to deploy with the slots that you have available. In the past, I ran 12-gun artillery batteries for most of the campaign, only boosting in them in the very late game after I had all my cores built. But with the decrease to accuracy combined with the smaller divisions, I'm playing around with boosting my artillery up to 18 to make up for some of that lost firepower. The AI will also prioritize counter battery when your guns are in range, so I'm using these 6-pound field guns and 12-pound howitzers to place at my most forward positions because they're easily replaced if I lose them. I've made 2 units of 2,500 to place in the forward wooded areas, along with 4 batteries of 18-gun smoothbores to provide support right behind them. I also have 1 24-pound howitzer, 1 ordnance rifle, and 1 20-pound Parrot. I've also created 3 1,000-man cav units to provide quick support to any area that needs it. Most of the assault forces will be towards the front, and my shooters will be holding the flanks. Since I'm holding the northern VP, all my 2nd Corps are faster moving units to get them in place quickly, so those are all skirmishers and 3-horse artillery. I'm taking on almost 50,000 CSA with my 29,000 troops. Keep an eye on the artillery batteries once the CSA move forward and get into place. I could have done more raiding behind enemy lines early to reduce the CSA guns, but I felt it was more important to use most of my KF to protect my units. In phase 1, I found that 3 infantry brigades with detached skirmishers and a smoothbore are enough to defend the right flank. I used a single unit with 2 detached skirmishers to protect the left flank. My KF ran wherever they were needed to provide support. Everyone else was deployed up front. I rotated my units as best I could to try to manage condition and attrition. Keep in mind that the AI needs to have at least condition of steady to start a charge in this version of the mod, so I keep rotating my guns to try to bring down the condition of the units before they start to charge as much as I can. Also, when each new phase starts, you want to get some recon out onto your flanks to see what's coming in. Once you are comfortable that you are not being flanked or that you have the flanking force under control, then you can move some of your units further north to support the center. Enjoy the battle, and I'll comment at the end. I wasn't able to produce enough of a push to collapse the AI and get a full clear, but I was able to inflict about 3-to-1 casualties. I lost 40% of my force here, which is more than Shiloh or Gaines' mill. I also lost 10 officers, including 2 of my division commanders. Overall, my army is still in decent shape. I have about 2,500 vets, over 200K in cash, and more weapons than I need. Plus, I have 2 side battles to get more cash before Second Bull Run so I can recover and keep on moving. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you at the next battle.